You are grinding your tricks. You're getting down all the things. You are going to level up. But you know what you should really make sure you're setting aside time for? Having fun with it. Drex here from Drex Factor Poi, sharing with you the love of poi spinning and flow arts to benefit your body and brain. And you know what I love most about spinning? The joy I get from it. But it's sometimes easy to forget about it. Before we dive in, I just want to give a quick shout out to the friends of the channel. Big thanks to Dark Monk, Flow DNA, Flow Fests, Flow Toys, Juggling Calling, Pyroterra Light Toys, Spin Balls, and Ultra Poi for helping to make the videos on this channel possible. You can learn more about all these amazing companies and the work that they're doing to support flow artists like yourself by checking out the links that I've got down in the description of this video. I have very, very vivid memories of early days as a tech spinner. Notebooks filled with diagrams and lists of new things to try. Chasing every hour of practice like it was a rare and precious commodity. And while I no longer have as much of a focus on tech as I once did, I still frequently find myself getting so deeply set into goal-oriented behaviors and mentalities that I'll kind of lose track of why I started spinning poi in the first place. It's fun! Especially as a content creator, it's not rare for me to get weeks where I'm grinding hard on writing and producing videos to the point that when I get to the end of the day, I just kind of feel wrecked and exhausted. I tend to shoot 4 weeks worth of videos in a single day, and while that means that I am indeed spending a lot of time spinning during the day, it's rarely in a particularly fun way. Now, don't get me wrong, I love making videos, and more than that, I love seeing the things that people do with the things that I teach them. But spending a solid hour repeating the same sequence of movements will grate on even the most passionate of flow artists. And there's a lesson that I frequently have to learn, and relearn as a result of that. If you're going to give short shrift to something, don't let it be the thing that you enjoy. I'll find myself after a week of intense work feeling run down and exhausted, even if I spun every day of the week. But when I'm diligent about making sure that I get out to spin for fun regularly, having unstructured flow time, dancing, and above all, just being present with the prop in a playful way, it does a lot more good for my mental health too. And this can be kind of a rough one when you're near to the beginning of your journey, especially when you're in that place where you've gotten your first few tastes of accomplishment and you want to learn all the things. All you want to do is spend all your time practicing. And don't get me wrong, that practice is incredibly important. The discipline you learn from it also impacts other areas of your life, to say nothing of the satisfaction that you get from the hours you invest in that improvement. But spinning for fun? Yeah, that's really important too. After all, if fun isn't the point, then why did you get started with it in the first place? I guarantee you it wasn't for the wealth or the status. I do love me some goal-oriented thinking. I love setting down those goals, knocking them down, and I love the feeling of accomplishment that comes with it. That's important for poi and important for lots of goals we set in life as well. But if your every moment with the prop is consumed by achieving these goals, that's also an easy way to burn out on the tool as well. I know more than a few people who approached spinning in this way and saw a lot of short-term success, only to crash and burn and lose interest in the longer term. Give yourself time to play. Give yourself time to enjoy. Give yourself time to express, explore, and grow without the goals hanging over you as much as you do letting them drive you forward and improving your work. Both are important. I sometimes forget that, and I'm willing to bet many of you do from time to time as well. Got anything out of this video? An important message? Something you want to pass on to others? Please make sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe to help other people find it and to help my channel grow. And I also just want to put out a huge thank you because this video would not be possible without the kind contributions of these wonderful folks right here. These are my Flow patrons on Patreon, and they, along with the wonderful people listed down in the description, make this video and all the videos on my channel possible. If you'd like to help me out in my mission to bring poi spinning and flow arts to the wider world and help people learn to be creative with their brains and their bodies, you can do so by heading over to patreon.com/drexfactorpoi and signing up. You can get early access to all of my content, a say in what topics I tackle in the future, plus some great extras and behind-the-scenes content as well. So go check that out. Please and thank you. What are your favorite ways to play with the prop? Leave me a comment and let me know. And please check out some of my other video blogs on a variety of topics related to poi spinning and the flow arts. I'll leave a link to the playlist of those videos down in the description, as well as up on screen if you're watching this video on YouTube. Make sure to get out and flow today, and have some fun doing it. And I'll see you with a new tutorial on Wednesday. Peace.